I wanted you for life. You and me in the wind. I never thought there'd come a time that our story would end. It's hard to understand, but I guess I'll have to try. It's not easy to say goodbye. For all the joy we shared, all that time we had to spend. Now if I had one wish, I'd want forever back again. To look into your eyes and hold you when you cry. It's not easy to say goodbye. I can remember all those great times we had. There were so many memories, some good, some bad. Yes, and through it all, those memories will last forever. There's peace in where you are. Maybe all I need to know. And if I listen to my heart, I'll hear your laughter once more. So I've got to say, I'm just glad you came my way. It's not easy to say goodbye.
If I had only known the last time would be the last time, I would have put off all the things I had to do. I would have stayed a little longer, held on a little tighter. Now what I'd give for one more day with you. There's a wound here in my heart where something's missing, and they tell me that it's gonna heal with time. But I know you're in a place where all your wounds have been erased, and knowing yours are healed is healing mine. The only scars in heaven, they won't be to me and you. There'll be no such thing as broken, and all the old will be made new. And the thought that makes me smile now, even as the tears fall down, is that the only scars in heaven are on the hands that hold you now. I know the road you walked was anything but easy. You picked up your share of scars along the way. Oh, but now you're standing in the sun. You fought your fight and your race is run. The pain is all a million miles away. The only scars in heaven, it won't belong to me and you. There'll be no such thing as broken, and all the old will be made new. And the thought that makes me smile now, even as the tears fall down, is that the only scars in heaven, yeah, are on the hands that hold you now. Not a day goes by that I don't see you. You live on in all the better parts of me. Until I'm standing with you in the sun, I'll fight this fight and this race I'll run. Until I finally see what you can see. Oh, the only scars in heaven, they won't belong to me and you. There'll be no such thing as broken, and all the old will be made new. And the thought that makes me smile now, and even as the tears fall down, is that the only scars in heaven are on the hands that hold you now.
Miss your voice, miss your smile, everything about you worth the while. Always wondering where you are. I hope you're with us, near or far. Many questions unanswered, I guess we're tears.
I can see it in your eyes that you are restless. The time has come for you to leave. It's so hard to let you go, but in this life I know you have to be who you were made to be. As you step out on the road, I'll say a prayer, so that in my heart, you always will be there. This is not goodbye. I know we'll meet again, so let your life begin, 'cause this is not goodbye. It's just I love you to take with you until you're home again. Soul has left you wondering, should you stay or turn around? Well, just remember that your dreams, they are a promise that you were made to change the world. So don't let fear stop you now, 'cause this is not goodbye. I know we'll meet again, so let your life begin, 'cause this is not goodbye. It's just I love you to take with you until you're home again. Oh, I know the brightest star above was created by the one who more than we'll ever know, to guide you when you're lost. What started as a still small voice is raging now, and your only choice is to follow who you are. So follow who you are, 'cause this is not goodbye. I know we'll meet again. This is not goodbye. I know we'll meet again, so let your life begin, 'cause this is not goodbye. It's just I love you to take with you until you're.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you.
And in your spirit.
In the waters of baptism, Lucas died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May he now share with him eternal glory.
Salamat sa iyo, aking Panginoon Jesus. Ako'y inibig mo at inangkit lubos. Ang mamahaling hiyas ni gintong nilukob ang tanging dalangin. O Diyos ay tanggapin ang tanging alay ko, nawa ay gamitin ito lamang, Ama, wala na. baba ako ang hinihiling. Di ko akalain na ako ay
Glory to God in the highest, and the earth is to be called of the Lord. He brings you, he blesses you, he adores you, he glorifies you, he gives thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High Jesus Christ, in the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, constantly accomplish the Paschal mystery within us, that those who are pleased to make you holy and baptism, may under your protective care bear much fruit and come to the joys of life eternal. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Reading from the Acts of the Apostles. After Paul and Barnabas had proclaimed the news to that city and made a considerable number of disciples, they returned to Lystra and to Iconium and to Antioch. They strengthened the spirits of the disciples and exhorted them to persevere saying, it is necessary for us to undergo many hardships to enter the kingdom of God. They appointed elders for them in each church, and in prayer and fasting, commended them to the Lord in whom they had put their faith. Then they traveled through Syria and reached Pamphylia. After proclaiming the word of Perga, they went down to Attalia. From there, they sailed to Antioch, where they had been commended to the grace of God for the work they had now accomplished. And when they arrived, they called the church together and reported what God has done with them and how he had opened the door of faith to the Gentiles. The word of the Lord. Amen. Responsorial song, let the response be, I will praise your name forever, my King and my God. My King and my God. The Lord is gracious and merciful, slow to anger and of great kindness. The Lord is good to all and compassionate toward all his works. His works, we praise your name forever, my King and my God. Let all your works give you thanks, O Lord, and let your faithful ones bless you. Let them disperse of the glory of your kingdom and speak of your mind. Response, we praise your name forever, my King and my God. Let them down, let them make home your might, the children of God, and the glorious splendor of your kingdom. Your kingdom is a kingdom for all ages, and your dominion endures through all generations. Response, praise your name.
reading from the book of Revelation. Then I, John, saw a new heaven and a new earth. The former heaven and the former earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. I also saw the holy city, a new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared to drive the bride of her husband. I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "Behold, God's dwelling is with the human race. He will dwell with them, and they will be his people, and God himself will always be with them as their God. He will wipe every tear from their eyes, and they shall be no more death, or mourning, wailing, or pain, for the old order has passed away." The one who sat on the throne said, "Behold, I make all things new." The word of the Lord.
That death is not an
believe that Lucas has gone to be with the Lord as we see. And we believe that one day we are going to also see him, because death comes to everyone, it comes to all. And now we are just exited to a better place than before. Revelation 6 to the 8 is a property. And he says, there God dwells with his people. He will be their God, and they shall be his people. He will wipe away their tears, and there will be no sadness again, because they see the face of the Lord everywhere. And we believe that through the mercy of God, through the love of God, that Lucas will receive that privilege that Jesus has promised all of us who believe in him. But the most important thing is for all of us who are still alive, how we live the life that we still have, this opportunity that we still have to make it up to God. The Gospel of today, Jesus says to the 12, now 11, because Judas had left, and he told them, I give you a new commandment, love one another. And in the end, John chapter 13, verse 35, he says, they will know that you are my disciples if you love one another. And my question is, how new is this? Because throughout the ministry of Jesus, he has always talked about love for each other. Matthew's Gospel says that you must love your neighbor as you love yourself. So how new is this new commandment? How new is this commandment that Jesus gives to his apostles, and he says, love one another? There is an addition to that. And he says, in the red, that as I have loved you, you also must love one another. It's not only about loving, but loving as Jesus loved. I'm sure the next question is, how did Jesus love? So the verse is better to the Romans. It says that it is difficult for somebody to die for somebody he loves. Just take for instance, a thief comes to your house in the middle of the night, and he has a gun with one bullet in it, and he asks you, who is prepared to die? I mean, it's difficult to sacrifice your life for your loved ones and say, I will die on behalf of my parents, on behalf of my brothers and sisters, on behalf of my child, on behalf of my son or my daughter. I say it is the difficulty that we will never to sacrifice for our loved ones. But to show how much God loves us, St. Paul says that he died for us while we were still sinners. He died for us while we were still his enemies. And that is what makes the love that Jesus has for us different from the love that we have for the loved ones, for our loved ones. Because Jesus loved us even while we were still his enemies. Jesus loved us while we were still sinners. And he says, therefore, we must love as he has loved us. Not that we only love those who love us in return, but we also love those who hate us. That is what makes us different from every other person. Matthew's Gospel already says, Jesus says to his people, to his disciples, and the Sermon on the Mount, he says, if you only love those who love you, even the beggars do as much. If you only forgive those who forgive you, even the beggars do as much. To make the difference is that we are going to love even those who hate us. Even those who don't have the same political opinions with us. Even those who voted, who vote for other people, for other candidates, who are not the candidates that we love, that we are going to love everybody as Christ loved us, while we were still sinners, while we did not deserve his love for us. And that poses a challenge to us, my dear brothers and sisters. Jesus says, they will know that you are my disciples. They will know that you are my follower. They will know that the Spirit of Christ lives in you if we can love each other. If we care for each other, if we forgive each other as readily as our Heavenly Father forgives us unconditionally, if we love each other as our Heavenly Father loves us unconditionally. My dear brothers and sisters, as we celebrate Easter, St. Paul said that the Corinthians say his death has lost its victory. Death has lost its sting. Death has lost its poison. Because Christ has defeated this very death through his resurrection. So, in the hope that we are a resurrection people, in the faith that we have in the resurrection of Christ, we believe that death is no longer an end. It is a doorway into life. And we believe that Lucas has crossed over in that new life. So while we stay on this earth, we must learn to love. That is the last of the commandments that Jesus gave to his disciples. Love as I have loved you. Love and forgive as I forgive those who did not crucify me on the cross. And I said to them, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they are doing. That kind of love. That Jesus breathed his last that we might have life. That he laid down his life that we might live. That he died on the cross and shame to death, that we might be redeemed. That is what he wants us to live by. My dear brothers and sisters, we continue to pray for the divorce of the soul of Lucas, the soul of Lucas, and as we continue to pray for the consolation of the family. We ask God in his love and mercy that we may be the loving people, that we may be truly prepared, follow the example that Christ has given us today, the example of love. And that Lord God with his love and mercy transport nation in the family of Lucas. The generous God of the people, Lord, and let your perfect love and friend of me. May so at the source of our affection departed through the mercy of God and rest in peace.
Let us now profess our faith. All, I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his own Son, our Lord. Let us pray to God, our Father, to keep us close to his loving heart so that we may be faithful to the new commandment he gave to us through which we shall be known as followers of his Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. With confidence we pray, Lord, keep us safe in your love.
Our church leaders to promote the dignity of every person. May they continue witnessing the genuine love for our brethren. We pray, Lord,
keep us safe in your love.
Guide the leaders of nations to foster compassion, to us to promote peace and love. Through the Spirit's counsel,
and come before you. Renew our hearts so that we may abide in your love and be genuine witnesses of your love towards the life of discipleship. Grant peace through Christ our Lord. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God Almighty. O God, who by the wonderful exchange effected in this sacrifice, have made us partakers of the supreme Godhead, grant, we pray, that as we have come to know the truth, we make it ours by a worthy way of life. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up our hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, all times to acclaim you, O Lord. But it is time above all to love you and pray gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. By the oblation of his body, he brought the sacrifices of all the fulfillment in the reality of the cross. And by commending himself to you for our salvation, showed himself the priest, the offer, and the Lamb of sacrifice. Therefore, overcoming us our joy, every land and people exalts in your grace, and even the heavenly powers and angelic hosts sit together at any hymn of your glory as they acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks to God and worthy to be in your presence and ministering. Humbly we pray that by taking of the body of God of Christ, we be gathered to one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember now your church spread to our world, and bring out the fullness of charity, without Christ our hope, considering our mission and all in the day.
Remember your servant in the beginning, whom you called, who is willing to this day, and who was connected with you in the person, and the other place, he also remember also our brothers and sisters who are following us in the children of the earth. And all who are praying in the wisdom, welcome them into the night of your face. Have mercy on us all that we pray. God, the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, who blesses those who are your spouse. We, the blessed apostles and all the saints who are faithful to all the believers, we may bury you before those who are eternal life. And we praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Thank you.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look now on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and give me in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sacrament. Let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those that inherit heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life. Through Christ our Lord. Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Lucas, and now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Lucas again and enjoy his friendship. Although this congregation will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother Lucas, in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Lucas in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant, and help us remain to comfort one another with assurances of peace until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our brother forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord. May he rest in peace. May his soul and the souls of people departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ and us as a man.
We have received countless of debts, calls, flowers,
can go from where they enjoy the peace of their lives and have been a reminder of the impact that he has had on so many others. Today, we honor, respect, and remember a very good man who touched and enriched all of our lives in so many different ways. His name is Luther Emanuel Borres. Let me try to put everyone, including myself, at peace here. He did not want this to be a sad day in our lives. He really didn't. But before I embark on this journey, I want to ask you a question. When you hear the name of Borres, what immediately comes to mind? There is no single word to choose from. But let me share a few that comes to mind. Palasyahe. Kirby ka pa kayo ay kapit ang parang kayo. Palainon sa mirror, dear, dapat red horse or sa hindi. Hindi magsundo, tipya maglalitaw sa mga Pilipino, romance movies, na dapat si Karakam, sige dapat ang star. And of course, love, love, it's a part of it. Isang mga family dogs naman. And of course, gusto niya na talaga, pero hindi na dapat siya mga dinner sa palagay niya. And each other. I'm sure there are some that you fully agree with, but hopefully there were also a few that surprised you. For time's sake, I just want to talk about this one certain memory I have of him. It was when Papa was admitted to the hospital.
Sa bawat puso'y muhaw sa pagsuyo. Magkatang Diyos natin, Diyos ng pag-ibig, magmahalan tayo't magtulungan.
No place to belong. But someday love is gonna lead you back to me. but duty doesn't have an empty heart. So I'll just have to believe somewhere out there you're thinking of me. Till the day I let you go, till we say our next hello, it's not goodbye. Till I see you again, I'll be right here remembering when. And if time is on our side, there will be no tears to cry on down the road. There is one thing I can't deny, it's not goodbye. You think I'll be strong in love to make it through and rise above when the wing falls down. But it's so hard to be strong when you've been missing somebody so long. It's just a matter of time, I'm sure. But time takes time and I can't hold on. So won't you try as hard as you can? You put my broken heart together again. Till the day I let you go, until we say our next hello, it's not goodbye. Till I see you again, I'll be right here remembering when. And if time is on our side, there will be no tears to cry on down the road. There is one thing I can't deny.
Many questions unanswered.
guess we'll never know.
So, pasensya again, since ang amon nga portable, hindi man makasarang for the, ano, for the power on. So, nagapangayog kami, pasensya, ma'am, sir. So, on behalf of the management and staff of Forest Lake Iloilo, we would like to extend our happy sympathy to the family Borres. We request everyone to please settle down.
But now you belong to heaven. It's empty without your smile. The truth brings us to tears. All the love you gave us all these years.
Everybody, please, can we please put on our cell phone into silent mood? We're about to start.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Our brother Lucas has gone to his rest in the peace of Christ. May the Lord now welcome him to the table of God's children in heaven, with faith and hope in eternal life. Let us assist him with our prayers. Let us pray to the Lord also for ourselves. May we who mourn be reunited one day with our brother Lucas. Together may we meet Christ Jesus when he who is our... You hallowed the graves of all who believe in you, and so made the grave a sign of hope that promises resurrection, even as it claims our mortal bodies. You are the resurrection and the life. Then he will see you face to face, and in your light will see light, and know the splendor of God, for you live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Because God has chosen to call our brother Lucas from this life to himself, we commit his body to this place. For we are dust, and unto dust we shall return. But the Lord Jesus Christ will change our mortal bodies to be like his in glory. For he is risen, the firstborn from the dead. So let us commend our brother Lucas to the Lord, that the Lord may embrace him in peace and raise up his body on the last day. We make our prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
So for our brother Lucas, let us pray to our Lord Jesus Christ, who said, I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me shall live even in death, and whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. You raise the dead to life. Give to our brother Lucas eternal life. We pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Comfort us in our sorrow at the death of Lucas. Let our faith be our consolation and eternal life our hope. We pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
We pray also for ourselves on our pilgrimage through life. Keep us faithful in your service. We pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Hail Mary,
full of grace,
the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of
grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son,
Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Hail Mary,
full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace,
the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
God of holiness and power, accept our prayers on behalf of your servant Lucas. Do not count his deeds against him, for in his heart he desired to do your will. As his faith united him to your people on earth, so may your mercy join him to the angels in heaven. Merciful Lord, you know the anguish of the sorrowful. You are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people who cry out to you in their need, and strengthen their hope in your lasting goodness. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord.
And let the perpetual light shine upon him.
May his soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace.
Amen.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. May the peace of God, which is beyond all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God, and of his Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. We make our prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May mighty God bless, keep, and protect you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
May I request everyone to please settle down. Good morning once again. On behalf of the management and staff of Forest Lake Iloilo, we would like to extend our deepest sympathy to the family Borres. At this moment of time, may I request one of the members of the family to please give your message on behalf of the family Borres. Come over. Before we're going to have a word, wala kita mo.
In behalf sa amon nga pamilya, salamat gid sa pagtambong nyo. Halin sa pagsugod nga si Lucas na mo nakalakan. Pero sa tuntuod, yung salamat kami nga nakalakan siya kay nag-antos man siya tungod siyang i-stroke. Anyway now, salamat man nga all the way hasta today. Ang mga kilala, mga amigo, at ang pamilya, thank you for joining us sa among nag-greet. O glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Father, Son, Holy Spirit.
Good morning, everyone. Thank you. First of all, thank you for attending this funeral. If some of you may not know, I am Nico, the son of Lucas the second, in behalf of my brother who is not here, because he's in abroad, I just want to say, my father, thank you for everything. I know our memories are very short and limited, but I am very proud to say that I am a Borres, I am part of the Borres family, and as Lola Violeta has always said that this family is very strong because they always pray together, and this is the proof that everyone is here. So thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. As a respect to the memory of our dear brother Luke Marie, we will go in to help the final viewing. And for those who wanted to make the last respect, kindly wear your face mask. May I request first the immediate members of the family to have your final respect to our dear brother Duke before we're going to bring him to his final.
In my heart, you love.
Appreciation for those who offered masses and prayers, sent flowers and messages of sympathy, and who in countless ways consoled with and comforted the family of our dear brother Duke Marie during their time of greatest sorrow. Your kind expression of sympathy shall always be remembered. Let us bow our heads and put ourselves in the presence of our Lord. Eternal rest grant unto the soul of our dear brother Duke Marie, O Lord, and let your perpetual light shine upon us.